Hello everyone, this is Radha Krishna. In this video, we are going to discuss on the seating chart applications. The main aim of this video is to understand the usage of the 2D arrays in C#.NET. In this seating chart application, each row is allocated with the different price labels. So based on the selection of a row and the column using the row text box and the column text box, when we click the display price button, we need to display the seat price based on the selection of the row and the column. So when we click the display price button, the event handler of the display price button opens. I have declared the two variables row and the column to loop through the 2D array. I have also created two constant variables, the maximum row equal to 5 and the maximum column equal to 3. As we know, there are rows from 0 to 5 and the columns from 0 to 3. So using these constant variables, we can validate the row and the column number not to be greater than the specified values. I have also created an array with all the price labels based on the row num. That is, row 0 has the 450, row 1 has 425, and so on. If you can observe, I have added almost comments at each and every point of the code so as to understand what is going to be executed using the below code. So for example, here I have written the comment as get the selected row number. So here I am checking for the row number that is entered in the row text box. Similarly, I am checking for the column number. So if the row number or the column number entered is the alphanumeric, automatically the error message throws here, because conversion of the alphanumeric into int returns an error, therefore the else part is executed then. So in the else part, I am displaying the message enter an integer value for the column, similarly enter an integer for the row. If the entered row number and the column number are both the numbers, then we are checking for the if the row is greater than or equal to 0 and less than maximum rows. That is, the maximum row here is 5. Similarly, we are checking for the column validation, whether the column value is greater than 0 and less than the specified maximum column value. If both conditions are satisfied, then we are displaying the price label with the price based on the row on the column that has entered. If the entered column value or the row value is greater than the maximum row or less than 0, then we are specifying the message that the column value must be 0 through the maximum column value. Similarly, for the row, that the row must be 0 through maximum row. On executing the application, if I enter the row as 0 and the column as 2, when I click the display price, I am getting the value of $450 as the seat price. So if I enter the row as 6 and if I click the display price button, we are displaying the message that the row must be 0 through 5.